In this video, we'll cover the probe microphone user calibration on Audioscan hearing instrument fitting systems. First, ensure probe microphones are properly connected. If this is your initial setup, see the user guide for detailed, model-specific instructions. Place a new probe tube on the probe microphone module. Do not attempt to sterilize probe tubes, as this process leaves residue which damages the probe microphones. The probe tube should be bent over and placed between the posts on the reference microphone side of the module. The tube must be positioned so that the tip is over the reference microphone opening. Hold the probe module up with the reference mic facing the REM speaker. Distance is not critical, but we recommend 15 to 90 centimeters, or 6 to 36 inches, from the speaker. From the tests menu, choose on-ear and calibration. Select the on-screen calibrate button for the probe mic you are calibrating. On VeriFit 2, the probe dock is designed to hold the microphones during calibration. Ensure that the probe tubes are correctly positioned over the reference microphones and the reference microphones are facing outward. Right-click and choose on-ear calibration. Hold the probe dock 15 to 30 centimeters or 6 to 12 inches from the speaker with the microphone to be calibrated facing directly towards it. Select the on-screen calibrate button for the probe mic you are calibrating. Then rotate the probe dock 180 degrees and repeat with the second microphone, clicking the on-screen calibrate button for the other side. The probe microphone coupled with the silicone probe tube does not have a flat frequency response. The user calibration process compares this response with the flat, factory calibrated response of the reference microphone and compensates all subsequent probe tube measurements for this difference. Calibration can be performed as often as desired, but will expire at 12 a.m. the following day or 12 a.m. the following Monday, depending on the choice of daily or weekly calibration interval. After the calibration has expired, you'll be prompted to calibrate whenever you attempt a test that uses the on-ear measurement microphones. You should recalibrate if a probe microphone is replaced or if a probe tube with different dimensions is installed. The calibration curve should be relatively smooth with gentle undulations in the high frequencies due to tube resonance. Overall level is not important and may vary from microphone to microphone, but typically only plus or minus 5 dB. Audioscan's new smart calibration monitors for improper curves and will flag errors and warn the user. While the user calibration may be performed weekly, Audioscan recommends an annual calibration check of the probe module reference microphone level. It is often convenient to have this done when other equipment is being calibrated. The technician will check the reference microphone against a calibrated sound level meter to ensure it has not drifted from factory calibration. Further details on this annual procedure are available in the user guide or the system help menu.